Growing up on a trap line, you learn a lot about winter survival. And after you go through the ice a few times and learn that freezing water is not all it's cracked up to be, ice safety eventually becomes sort of second nature. I'm out traveling an area away from my trap line right now for a job with the Canadian Parks and Wilderness Society. With me is my friend, co-worker, and fellow biology major, Mackenzie. We've been employed, along with another guy named Joseph, to monitor the movement of threatened woodland caribou in this area of the forest, and a large part of our fieldwork involves traveling into remote areas to set up trail cameras. Many of these remote areas have not been traveled by another human for years, and so we have to be extremely cautious as we travel. And as a lifetime of experience on the trapline has taught, not falling into freezing water is a really important part of not dying out here. One of the issues with ice in this area is that it's incredibly variable. This small river, for example, proves to be frozen at least 10 inches thick when we test it with the hatchet. Consequently, it acts as an excellent travel route, allowing us to follow it and get off the trail into some more caribou-friendly habitat. However, not all ice up here is so safe and helpful. The topography of this area is littered with peat moss bogs, which are notorious for creating treacherous ice conditions. The moss can trap heat, preventing the ice from freezing properly. Other times, as the streams in this area generally drain the bogs, the water level can drop far below the ice level as the main water systems drain, leaving a deceiving layer of apparently thick ice atop a void that can swallow a snowmobile in an instant. The problem is, these streams often seem perfectly safe to travel on. And this is why proper ice safety practices are so crucial to survival in this part of the world. We need to take is right there. Doesn't really look like a road, but we have to cross this stream. It looked like it was okay until I stepped on it, and it sounded really hollow, so I gave it a kick, and apparently it is very much not okay. So thank goodness we didn't try snowmobiling on it, or we would be really hooped right now. But this is kind of cool. You can look underneath and like see way underneath the ice there. It just runs along through under there. I'm not sure how far, but a long ways. And, I mean, I dropped the ice by kicking it, thankfully, before I stepped on it. But here's kind of a view you don't get very often of how they enter their channels. So that hole there would go in, open right up into the beaver house. That's his entrance right there. Not being used right now. I don't think there's any beavers in this old house, but that's kind of how they come and go. It's pretty cool. Ice can be pretty deceiving. It sure looks like it should be solid, but as we've been seeing in this area, it is totally not solid. And that's how you drop a snowmobile into water 4 feet down and end up spending a night out in the bog. Thankfully, we've avoided that so far. We're gonna try and continue avoiding it.